All right, good morning. A traditional video on the weekend, outdoor. So today I want to talk about what are relationships between bill of materials and purchasing process. So unless you're a very large company running very sophisticated and complex supply chain management system, I bet your purchasing process is a bunch of Excels, emails, and purchasing from the website. So, and to manage it efficiently, you need to have some system in place that can help you to do so. But the system is not enough. A system should have a reliable source of information to manage this purchasing. So bill of materials, when you run the export of data from CAD system, can kind of give you this source of information, but it's still very one-side focused. So it's give you data from your design system. A design system doesn't include all information that you need, and some parts needs to be purchased based on different criteria. You probably know I have this bunch of screws that needs to be purchased every month, and we don't include them in a CAD model. That's probably the most typical example you can see, but for your company, you can find some other examples. So making all data from design systems is not enough. The second thing is most important is to make this system complete. So to make this data complete, to include everything that you need. So you can plan for cost, you can plan for purchasing. The other thing of this process is to connect this data to two additional sources of information. The first is from whom you buying, the vendor, and the second is the amount of parts that you have in stock from the previous runs, from the previous purchases. So to have this all information together, to have this all together, you need to have kind of system. Excel is a better idea to use it. So that's why bill of materials, with the right connection of data to vendors and the right connection of data to what amount of parts you have in the stock, is the system that can help you to make your next purchasing process much more efficient and prevent your next nightmare about some parts being forgotten or making it to the production shop floor not on time. So sounds simple, yes, but I see many companies that are struggling in this process and run in a lot of complexity. So at OpenBOM, we think how to make this process more seamless and easy, and that's why we invented design to purchase process in OpenBOM. Take a look on the link in our website, and it will give you an idea how OpenBOM design to purchase process works. And I will talk to you later. Thank you very much and have a lovely weekend. Bye-bye.